We are back here at Down to Earth's Community Room. We are with Mama T, and I don't know what this is. What is this, Mama T?
This is a mandolin, but not the kind that makes music. It's a wonderful little gadget that slices vegetables really, really thinly.
So I think I've seen this on TV.
Yes. They have them. I've seen them at Ross, but this is the Pamper Chef one, and it's a really good one. So we're going to put our beets in there.
What are we making today?
We're making raw beet sashimi, and we're going to slice our beets really thin. Look how wonderful that is. But the wonderful thing about it is when we add all of our marinade, the beets get really, really tender, almost like sashimi, just melting in your mouth.
Raw beet sashimi?
Yes. So this is a cruelty version of your typical sashimi that you would find at a sushi restaurant.
Wow.
And look how beautiful
look at that
is. We're gonna have you add a handful of those green onions. I'm going to put in some tamari, and we're gonna put in some of that maple syrup next to you.
All right.
We're also gonna put in some toasted sesame. The longer this marinates, the better it gets. And we're gonna put in some lemon zest. And I also wanna put in some lemon juice. So let me give this a cut and see. Oh, I see that.
I'm so curious to know what this tastes like.
So good. Now I'm gonna have you squeeze this in here with our, we don't have our little thing, so you're just gonna have to do it that way. We're also going to put in some grated ginger. I'm using a microplaner. The more you get into cooking, you get to get these cool little gadgets and find them.
But you know what? Maybe that would make me enjoy cooking more.
To get the gadgets.
Yes.
That's how I feel. I get really excited to get new gadgets. Alrighty, so we're gonna put in our ginger. You can put as much as you want, little as you want. But I'm telling you, this dish is delicious. And we wanna make sure that the liquids are covering. So this is one that I have had marinating for a while.
Wow.
And you can see that it's just really soft. The beets melt in your mouth. People who don't even like beets tell me that they like this raw beet sashimi. So we're gonna put this in here, let this marinate and chill in the refrigerator for like 1 to 2 hours.
So you can kind of see how the beets changed after having
that. Oh, yes, they're kind of firm and crunchy. Some people prefer them crunchy like this.
Mm-hmm.
But I like it so they melt in your mouth.
Okay.
And then what we have here is plated. Beautiful plate. Isn't that pretty?
It looks like sashimi.
Right.
Wow.
And then we topped it with some gamasio. And I'm not sure where I put that, but somewhere. And then you can just sprinkle a little bit of gamasio, which is some sea salt and seaweed and some delicious sesame seeds on there.
I'm so curious.
Let's see. Yes, and the ones that are in the juice are really the most fabulous. Like, I could drink this, Trini, like this. It's so delicious, the juice. Try one out of here, too, Trini.
That is really good.
I know. Try one that's been marinating and is really, really, really soft. Mm-hmm. See if you can get one of those. They're so delicious. See how soft
this one's
that
softer,
is?
Yeah.
Right? And they get softer and softer and softer.
It gets softer, but it still has a nice crunch.
It has a little texture to it.
That's good.
It does. Mm. Yummy, huh?
That is so clever. So creative. Yay. Yummy, yummy. So,
as a vegetarian, I missed sashimi. I used to eat sashimi, so I wanted to create something that I could still have the flavors, and beets did a good job.
All right. Now we're going to have the link to this this recipe on our website so everybody can find out, and that's just one of 2,000
recipes at downtoearth.org. Please visit our website. Come visit Jordan and I at the classes and also the lectures. We love to engage with our community and with Trini here.
And they have great workshops, folks, so you have to come on down. Mama T, thank you so much.
Mm,
I'm gonna try another one.
Aloha.
Isn't that such a smart idea for a dish?
And really, it does look like just, it really, I was amazed.
And it really tasted good. And you said you like beets,
love beets.
Right?
My grandmother used to actually make borscht soup back in the day, so I am definitely going to go and try that recipe out. And like you said, so many on their website.
Yes, thousands.
Mm-hmm.